Before we get into today's show, if you love, as Alabama and Nick Saban tend to call it, joyless murder ball, then like the video right now. I would say, before we get too far, I think there was some joy for Alabama in that game. There was plenty of murder ball and certainly no joy for Middle Tennessee. If you enjoyed it, like the video right now. On today's show, we will break down the official Alabama depth chart, since that has been released as part of the media guide that came out before the Alabama-Middle Tennessee game. And we'll break down how the snap count either matched or didn't match that in week one. Some minor injury updates, but things went pretty well for the Crimson Tide in week one. To the surprise of nobody, they manhandled Middle Tennessee 56-7, damn near covered the over-under by themselves, which would be the case when you were a massive favorite. The big story going into the game was, what was the quarterback room going to look like? How was that all going to be handled? And although the top three guys, Jalen Milroe, Tyler Buckner, and Ty Simpson, all did play, we, as media, were right for the most part on they were all going to play, was very, very clear who your starting quarterback is right now. Jalen Milroe was out there to start. He had 45 snaps in this game. Tyler Buckner had 13. Ty Simpson had 8. For the most part, coming when the game, I guess you could argue the game was out of hand the moment they stepped on the field, but when the game was statistically out of hand. And I thought Milroe looked fantastic. 13 of 18, 194 passing yards, 3 touchdowns, no interceptions. Added 48 yards on the ground. He was, by the way, Alabama's leading rusher. He had more than everyone else did, and they ran it a lot. Give the guys good get to their backs in a little bit here. I was impressed by Milroe becoming the first Bama quarterback to have 2 rushing touchdowns and 3 passing touchdowns in a single game. He's your starter. Now, doing it against Middle Tennessee is one thing. Doing it against Texas, against the SEC, as bad as maybe schools like Florida looked in week one, is a very different conversation. So I do want you guys to grade Jalen Milroe's performance against Middle Tennessee State, A, B, C, D, or F. I'm giving it an A. I don't know what you're giving it, producer Chris Bryan. I am factoring in it's Middle Tennessee, like it should have always been really good, but I didn't have very many complaints to have in that game. So go sound off for me at the pinned comment of today's video. Grade Milroe's performance A, B, C, D, or F, especially if the ad comes here on YouTube. Let's move to the running back room. And this was kind of a rotation. Again, they rotated a lot of guys in. Jace McClellan had 20 snaps. Roydell Williams had 19. Those are your top two backs right now. Justice Haynes, Jam Miller had 11 and 10 respectively. Richard Young have 5. So some clear delineation of the starters, the lead backs, the second-tier backs, which will be featured heavily in this season. McClellan, 10 for 39 on the score. Roydell, 7 for 36. Justice Haynes, 4 for 29. I will give Richard Young some credit. 5 snaps, carried the ball on every single one of them because the game was well and truly out of hand. The wide receivers. Now, this is a very interesting group where Jermaine Burton had 40 snaps. Isaiah Bond had 39. Ja'Cory Brooks did not play in the first half. He still finished with 20 snaps. Kendrick Law had 18. Malik Benson had 17. Kobe Prentice had 16. Jalen Hale had 13. So, again, clear separation of Burton and Bond, with maybe Brooks is going to end up being your true wide receiver 3 because he missed the first half. Then Law, Benson, Prentice, and Hale. Not any real reps, by the way, for our guy Emmanuel Henderson. Makes me sad, producer Chris. We'll see what the future holds there. Jalen Hamilton played 3 snaps there. Shaz Preston, also played 3. Now, you can get an Alabama jersey customized for yourself, customized for a player, or a throwback jersey for some historic players for 25% off. chatsports.com/AlabamaJersey. That link will be in both the comment section and the description of today's show. Fantastic deal. Get it now so you have it in time for the meat of the SEC schedule. chatsports.com/AlabamaJersey. We'll make this a slightly different tight end depth chart graphic from what you saw last time because both Amari Nyblak, producer Chris's all-time favorite player, slight exaggeration, but he's a huge fan, and T.J. Dupree both played a good amount, 34 snaps for Nyblak, 22 for Dupree. They both kind of rotated in there. I think you'll see a heavy rotation of those two guys, some two tight end looks. But a lot of other guys played. Robbie Utes played 17 snaps. Danny Lewis only got 12. Miles Kitzelman and Ty Lockwood played a couple snaps. Those 8 and 3 snaps, you'll probably take those away in the games that are closer. Maybe give them all to Dupree, and it kind of ends up being similar numbers to Nyblak, but we'll see how it all plays out. But we do have a better feel now for what this depth chart's really going to look like. All right, the offensive line. Much was made. How many snaps does Elijah Pritchett get? Who's your left tackle? Well, Seth McLaughlin, Tyler Booker, J.C. Latham, and Caden Proctor all played 57 snaps. Your starting left tackle is going to be Caden Proctor, barring injury. Darian Doucourt played 43. Terrence Ferguson got 21, so they did give a couple reps extra to Ferguson. Miles McVay played 9. James Brockermeyer played 9. Jaden Roberts played 7. Everyone else played 2 on the back end of that third string offensive line. So you have your starting 5. It is Proctor. It is Booker. It is McLaughlin. It is Doucourt. It is J.C. Latham. That is going to be your starting 5 this year, barring injury for the Crimson Tide. So now that we know what it is with Proctor beating out Pritchett, what is your confidence level in this offensive line for Alabama? Scale it for me from 1 to 10. 1 on the low end, 10 on the high end. Let's check in now in the secondary, where Cooley McKinstry seems like he's fine, by the way, after the injury. Jalen Key, Malachi Moore, who both played a good amount of snaps, by the way, seems like they're fine. Day-to-day was the official designation there. With some of the injuries that happened, I don't know how much we can read into the snap counts. But Kool-Aid McKinstry, Terrion Arnold were your leaders at corner. Then it was Trey Amos, Caleb Downs, Malachi Moore, Jalen Key, and that safety star. We'll kind of group that spot together. Christian Story played 27. Earl Little ended up playing 20. Jake Pope-Pitt played 10. Tony Mitchell, the true freshman, got 6 snaps in there, by the way. You know, there's been some, you know, Devonta Smith's injured right now. He might have mixed in there at safety, but I think the rotation very clear. Downs, Arnold, McKinstry, Moore, Amos, Key, Story, and maybe Little is your next man up there. The linebackers, do make note that Jihad Campbell had his knee scoped, so he's going to miss some time. So it ended up being Deontay Lawson, who I thought looked fantastic in that game. He was all over the field. I think it was 7 tackles, a sack, and 2 TFLs. Great results against, again, lesser competition, but it's all we have to go off of right now. Dallas Turner, Chris Braswell. They did give a good amount of run to both Kendrick Blackshire and Quandarius Robinson. Saw some Sean Murphy, saw some Keanu Coate. Again, they rotated a lot of guys in there late. You had, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 different guys play snaps at either off-ball, linebacker, or edge, which I do think makes some sense. I was impressed by Lawson. With that in mind, do you have more confidence in the linebacking room this year for Alabama? We'll call it mostly inside linebackers, but you can group in the edges too if you want. Y for yes, N for no. All right, the defensive line room now. Top 3 snap getters were Justin Ebwojibi, Tim Keenan, and Jaheim Otis. So they're going to go heavy up front with Otis and Keenan both being able to play nose guard. They'll give them some defensive end and some pure nose guard reps there. Tim Smith played 20 snaps. Damon Payne got 13. James Smith only played 6. We will see if he ends up being a 4-game guy to redshirt or ends up being more than that. The kick return, this again, the depth chart version, pretty clearly Kendrick Law. He was the only one to get a chance to return a kick in this one. It was a 23-yard return, so nothing too special, but seems like he's got the job locked in over Ja'Cory Brooks. He also had Terrion Arnold on there, which I found pretty interesting. Cole Adams as well. Adams is also listed as one of the backup punt return man. Kool-Aid McKinstry, 5 for 66. It's actually pretty good. The long of 33 doing the big workload there. But, hey, he's a playmaker. Get the ball in his hands as long as he stays healthy. Isaiah Bond was the backup. Just had 1 for 1 yard, so not much there. And then no change here to your special teams unit. Will Richard is your kicker. They did give Connor Talty an extra point. I would guess they're only going to give him 4 games to preserve the red shirt. But, hey, you know, it was 56-7. Why not give him a kick? Since I think initially they kind of thought Will might go pro. James Burnip had 3 punts for 139 yards, 46-yard average. It's good. Hopefully he's not doing too much there. And then long snapper Nealon Hibbett as well. If you guys are hyped and ready for Alabama versus Texas, should be a fantastic matchup. Then hit that sub button right now. We'll have coverage for you this week. Make sure you don't miss out. Subscribe right now.